at the end of year 12, there is this slight pressure and tendency sometimes to follow the routine areas of study. What I've learned, I think, since then is that it actually doesn't really matter so much what everyone suggests is the way to go. The thing that will ultimately be driving us forward is ultimately that reason of, well, why am I doing it? Is it because I really want to do that for the people that I'm working with? And I think in the end it's those things that really power you forward when it gets a little bit trickier. I was one of those people, I think, in year 11 and 12, that I felt like maths and science is really where I was at. But I think studying humanities at university has taught me to value things that are subjective. And that's been a really big thing, to know that it's not all about getting the black and white answers and actually exploring people's lives and exploring communication and understanding and insight are of such value, even though we're not always able to quantify them. The other thing that is probably a funny outcome of it is actually this fear of not making mistakes. I think in science we are often bound to things that are hypothesized, correct, incorrect, but I think in music, and for me, funnily enough, singing in a choir was something that taught me that you must never be afraid to make mistakes. I remember my choir conductor saying that you have to be adventurous and try and start when you think the piece is going to start, because if you wait for every other person next to you, it's like all the cars lining up at a red light. By the time you wait for every other person to start, you'll be so far behind and the group will be totally out of time. And that's one of the things that I found most applicable in my study of medicine, is being able to reason and talk to teachers and peers alike and say, you know, I think this is like this and this is why. And please tell me if this is right or wrong, because in the end, that's going to help me to grow and learn. And don't we want our future generation of practitioners to be as knowledgeable as they can be on all these areas? When my wife and I, who met in music, finished studying music, we were lucky enough to be able to pull together a sort of group of friends who were keen to make music together past our university days. And so we're part of two groups. One is called Serenate and one is called Lucem Vitae. And essentially we still try and perform as much as we can, often at Christmas, but also around other areas as well. In my journey of doing something quite specific, I've then actually met a number of people who I've realised share some similar passions, a small number of whom are actually doing exactly the same thing that I am, so I'm glad to have someone doing the same. But otherwise, seeing lots of medical students interested in music and similarly music students interested in health. And so it's been really great to be able to share that together and to be able to encourage them, and I think future students as well who are interested in those things, to essentially say that when you love music this much, it's not something you can ever let go, really, whatever you decide to do.